Welcome to the IAF Client Portal. We've created this brief video to assist you complete and submit project reports. Please note, depending on the program you are reporting on, different questions or information may appear on the report. But this tutorial should assist you with the basics of any IAF project reporting. You will receive a prompt by email when your report is ready. To start your report, log in to the IAF Client Portal. From the home screen, to begin a report, click here on Report Due under the Report section. Here you'll find any reports ready for your attention. Please note the due date here. You may be sent the report well before you are ready to begin completing it. This is to allow you the opportunity to see the items you may need to report on, and optionally, you may complete the elements of your report as your project is executed to avoid the rush at the end of your project. To start a report, click the Edit button at the top of the page. For the purposes of this tutorial, we are completing a BC Climate Agri Solutions Fund report, but all the reports function in essentially the same way. Also of note, the data we're providing here is made up and completely inaccurate. For most projects, you will find a summary of the approved funding at the top of the report for your reference. Now complete the report information as prompted. This is just like the application forms. For this project, you can see we're not funded for nitrogen management, so there's no need to complete this section. If you see a section with a green plus sign, please click the circled plus sign and select the relevant items. There are two ways to provide your invoice information. For this example, we'll use the invoice summary. By clicking the plus button here, a line is added and we can populate it as required. You can add up to 10 items in the invoice summary section. We'll address what to do if you have more than 10 in a moment. Carry on providing your project information and costs. Note, we've put the total cost of the project here, not the amount we're requesting for reimbursement. The reimbursement amount is automatically calculated here. You can save the form at any time. To do so, you may have to provide your name and accept the attestation at the bottom. To make the changes and add more information, click the Edit button. Back in the report, we'll demonstrate what you do if you have more than 10 invoices. Click this link here, Invoice Summary. That will prompt you to download an Excel spreadsheet. If it doesn't pop up, look at the top of your browser for a notification of a blocked pop-up. You can now complete the Invoice Summary Excel spreadsheet. Note, as we populate the information, a summary is calculating of the total activity costs at the bottom of the form, which the reporting form will require you to input. Once the invoice summary is completed and saved, head back into the report. Input your total project costs and carry on with the required information. For this program, there isn't a requirement to upload all the receipts and invoices when you first submit. The IAF team will request the invoices and proofs of payment when they review the report. But if you have completed an invoice summary, ensure you upload the summary here. Optionally, if you would like to share the success of your project, we've created a space for you to do so here. These stories may be used for promotional materials or shared with the program funders in future. As this report is now complete, we'll click Save and Continue. We can now review the information and click here to submit. If we refresh our browser, the report now has a status of received. The IAF team will review the report and be in touch with any required invoices. It's been a few days, and we've received an email from IAF requesting invoices. When we log into the IAF Client Portal and select the report, we can see the request here at the top. Click Edit at the top of the page and scroll down to the bottom to upload the required invoices. Please pay special attention to the direction here about naming the invoices, as this will speed up the process and ultimately speed up your payment. Click Save and Close. And once you're back at this screen, click Resubmit. If you'd like to check the status of your report at any time, you can see that here in the client portal. Once it's approved, you will receive an email. If there is a payment being issued as a part of your report, you can see the status of your payment here in the Payments section. This is also a great time to remind you to sign up for electronic funds transfer to receive your payments directly to your bank account. See our tutorial on how to add an EFT information for more details. We hope this tutorial has been helpful. Please reach out if you need any assistance. We're always here to help.